2020 has been a year in which the world has changed irrevocably, but for all the uncertainty, everything that feeds into the new normal, leave it to Samsung to give us some semblance of techie familiarity that brings everything back into sharp focus with a new line of Note devices for the second half of the year, just like clockwork. Part of Samsung's August 5th Unpacked event, which also played host to new tablets, smartwatches, headphones and more, was fronted by the Galaxy Note 20 line, namely the Note 20 and the Note 20 Ultra. If the name doesn't give it away, the Ultra is the Don Daddy, the true flag bearer of this year's Note lineup, and naturally it comes with a ton of features. But for everything Samsung mentioned on stage, here are a few inclusions you might have missed. Long-time Note users may pick up the Note 20 and feel like something's off. For the first time on a Note device, the S Pen now slides out from the bottom left corner, while all of the hardware controls, the volume and power keys, are located along its right side. Why? Samsung says this is to allow for that sizable new camera bump, which features a 108-megapixel main sensor with OIS, a 12-megapixel telephoto sensor with OIS and a 5x optical zoom, and a 12-megapixel ultra-wide just for good measure. The Note 9's S Pen features focused on productivity, whilst the Note 10 added a little more creativity to the mix. With the Note 20, you're getting new air gestures that focus on ease of use and navigation. Previous air gestures operated on an app-by-app basis, but on the Note 20, you can use its anywhere actions to do things like navigate between apps, jump back to your home screen, and access features like Screen Write and Smart Select. It's also worth mentioning that Samsung's managed to reduce the latency down to an Apple Pencil rivaling 9 milliseconds on the Ultra, and that this new S Pen features just 7 minutes charge time, which will give you 20 minutes of gesture time and up to 10 hours of standby. Samsung Notes is still the go-to app for any S Pen related note-taking, but on the 20, if you want to scribble down notes at any odd angle, you can straighten them right back up with a single tap. Samsung and Microsoft have also built in the ability to export to the likes of PowerPoint, and there's now synchronization between both Microsoft Outlook and OneNote. Whether it's for battery life purposes or as a limitation of the Exynos 990 at the Note 20's heart, like the S20 line, you're forced to choose between enjoying the full splendor of the Ultra's 6.9-inch WQHD Plus Dynamic AMOLED 2X display, or enjoying content at up to 120Hz. Despite some hoping that with the Note being the Note, Samsung would actually let you lock the refresh rate this time around, it's still fully automated, for better or worse. The Galaxy Note series probably offers some of the best video capture on an Android device, and with the Note 20 Ultra, Samsung's upped its game yet again. Audio-wise, you now get on-screen levels when shooting in Pro Mode, and the ability to select a microphone bias from Omni to front, rear, or even use wired or wireless external mics. New Galaxy Buds Live wearers will also benefit from additional background noise cancellation in their videos by using the microphones in the Buds Live while shooting on the Note. Two other small mentions go to single take, which can now be extended up to 15 seconds at a time, and an improved zoom slider, which allows for more finesse to control. Like I said at the start, we've just scratched the surface of what this new Note 20 line brings to the table, and it's clear that Samsung's left no stone unturned for this latest generation. Keep it locked to TechAdvisor for more, and we'll have a full review of the Note 20 Ultra for you very soon. Thanks for watching.